Cases of canine influenza or dog flu have been creeping up around the country. I've been hearing so much about this, and as the owner of three dogs, it's a little concerning. Veterinarians want pet owners to be prepared for more possible cases in 2019, but we're going to try to give you some tips now to keep your pets safe. Obviously, veterinarians are recommending the canine influenza vaccine. Then look out for symptoms, especially if your dog is part of doggy daycare with other dogs. But symptoms like reduced appetite, high fever, cough, runny nose, and lethargy, kind of the same symptoms that we as humans suffer from. And if left unchecked, just like humans, it can progress into pneumonia. There's lots of, you know, different options here. You get the vaccine, but might be treated with antibiotics or other medications. A lot of coverage on flu prevention for humans, but what about us pet owners? What can we do for our dogs? Lauriston Crockett has developed several anti-aging products for pets. He's a pet health and longevity expert. He joins us right now from where, Denver?
No, I'm in Dallas.
Dallas. I got the other big D. What's going on, man? How are you?
Good morning, JD. Good morning.
Now, you're going to be on a big podcast later today, I think, right?
I will be on a podcast, yes. It's called Your Pets Radio. And today we're talking about the side effects of spaying and neutering and what this actually does to your pet's health. And I'll be on there with the famous pet vet, Dr. Danny Cox.
Oh, that is so cool. That is all right. So, listen, what can we do to prevent the dog flu? Obviously, I said to get the vaccine, but what
else?
Well,
the dog flu is basically airborne, okay? So, you know, we have to also worry about dogs that have been infected with it. They're coughing, barking, sneezing. You know, they can be inhaled by the canine host. Also, you need to worry about going to different locations or dog shows. And you can also be spread through water bowls, collars, kennels. And also, if you've been out and been around a dog that is infected with this H3N8 or H3N2 influenza, then when you go home, you need to wash your hands, wash your arms, wash your clothes, because you can still infect your own pet.
And it has no seasonality.
It does not. You are right on point, my friend. It does not. And it also, you know, it started back in 2004. Basically, it jumped over from horses into greyhound racing dogs in Florida in 2004.
Wow.
So we've only been dealing with it a short period of time.
Wow. This is kind of startling. It seems like there's more and more cases popping up everywhere now.
Well, there is. And, you know, and you can talk to your local vet and find out, are you having an outbreak in your area? And if you are, you know, let's just be preventive, just like we are. You know, let's make sure that we're not putting our dogs around other dogs that could possibly beat us. And, you know, they're more highly contagious during the incubation period when they're not even showing signs of the flu virus. So we need to be careful.
Your website, thegiftforlife.com. Tell me what your mission is. Tell me what you're up to right now.
Well, basically, it's all about pet longevity and health, and we need to really get serious about the truth about spaying and neutering. Spaying and neutering, when you do this to a male or female, basically the animal is only producing 1% of the hormones it did before this elective surgery. We now know that this could lead to three forms of cancer: Addison's disease, Cushing's disease, hypothyroidism, ligament tears, diabetes, and it goes on and on and on to hip dysplasia, believe it or not. And so what we've been able to do with the peptide technology is stop, reverse, or slow down these side effects. And also, pets over the age of 8, we're able to give them natural hormonal support because we can turn on their adrenal cortex and they start producing 24 lost hormones. Their body starts producing it instead of outside synthetic hormones.
Wow, man, this is state-of-the-art stuff.
It is. It is. We're changing lives, and usually you can start seeing results and could start seeing results as little as 4 days. Matter of fact, if you have a senior pet out there, put them in my care for the next 30 days. Give me just 4 days, and I bet you start seeing a lot more energy, less joint pain relief. And a lot of people talk about this, but it's all about the peptides, which give life, and naturally occurring growth factors that give life. And this is how we're going to turn this around.
Hey, you and I are going to stay in touch. Lauriston Crockett from it's Pet Health and Longevity. That's basically thegiftforlife.com. That's your website.
It is thegiftforlife.com.
Yeah, I'm sure it's going to be. We're going to get some hits on that website right now. Thanks, Lauriston. Thanks for coming.
Thanks, buddy.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. I look forward to talking with you.
All right.